The Mana series holds a special place in my heart and in gaming history. Now, growing up on Secret of Mana, playing that game to full completion with my little brother is a memory that I will cherish forever. Yet knowing that there was another Mana game out there stuck over in Japan that I couldn't play, that was a major disappointment. Though as time passed, Square Enix did release a few Mana games over here and there in the West, but yet they never were able to stand up to how truly amazing The Secret of Mana was at its core. Hello everybody, Brian here for Ginger Prime Gaming, and I want to put this out here right at the top of the video. Trials of Mana Remake does not have any multiplayer. Learning this came with a lot of disappointment, but yet I have still pre-ordered and already installed the game on my Switch. The reason is why is because even without multiplayer, the Trials of Mana Remake is incredible. The other thing that I want you, and I think you should know, is having played this game both on PC and Switch, I found that for some reason, on the PC version, there was some performance issues, some light stutters, a little bit of jitter here and there. While on the Switch, it felt like it ran amazingly well. I can only assume the PS4 looks and plays better than the Switch, but I would say that console might be the safest bet if you're considering picking up this game. Square Enix has had some trouble in the past with their PC ports, and by the time you're watching this video, maybe all that's fixed and taken care of, but I just wanted to make sure you had all the information possible when either deciding to play this game or where to play this game. Now on this channel, you're going to find a getting started guide for Trials of Mana. This is where I break down the different characters, what you should select, how the game systems work, because truly, this game is a masterclass of an action RPG. It does some things that I do find annoying, but it has nothing to do with the gameplay or the world. To put it simply, some of the characters' voices and the characterization I could easily do without. Not throwing hate on anyone's favorite character out there, but personally, I really just don't like Charlotte. Her voice and semi-baby talk style just is not my cup of tea. However, the characters each and all play very well on their own, and they each have their own unique flavor. Now, where Secret of Mana, you had different weapons that kind of augmented your playstyle with the different characters, here you have classes, and then as you level, you unlock skills, and as you unlock the different mana spirits, you can really build out a unique team in many different interesting ways. However, you have to pick that team right from the front. So if you're curious about that, be sure to check in the description below when that video is up. I'll have a link for you, and that way you can dive in and make the best decision possible when starting this game. Now, just like the original, you start the game off by selecting your main character and picking your two companion characters who you'll actually meet as the story progresses. Each start of the story is unique, but you'll soon find yourself on the same mission no matter who you select. Even though some of the story and dialogue are different, the game is primarily voiced, and to a degree, it's actually pretty well done, with a few exceptions. And overall, the story flow is the same flow right out of the gate. So if you're looking for that classic feel, you can go pick up the Collection of Mana, which is going to have this included. However, I think the gameplay innovations and just the overall flow is that you'll find it more comfortable playing the remake than the original, personally speaking. Now visually, this world is beautiful, and the upgrade is very welcome. The world comes to life, and it feels just like a Mana game brought into 2020. But here's where the game shines, is in its gameplay. The moment-to-moment, both jumping, running, dodging, the combat, it all feels so good and so fluid that it's really hard to put the controller down for a break. And since I'm personally playing on the Nintendo Switch, this doesn't have to end with me wanting to walk away from the TV because I can just pick it up and play on the go. The world is also filled with things to find and things to collect, and it really makes me hope for more Mana games set up like this in the future, only I would love to see multiplayer added back in. So I was originally planning on picking up this game on Steam, until I found out that it was a solely single player experience. And while nothing is wrong with that or single player games overall, I was hoping to be able to dive back into this game with my brother once more, only over the internet, rather than in our living rooms. Now, if you're on the fence about this game, the best thing I can tell you is wait for a sale or discount. This game offers a lot, and I'm really impressed by what Square Enix has done here. I hope to see more from the Mana series in the future, and for a long time, it honestly, the Mana series felt abandoned, left to the memories of my youth, but here I am today, playing a Mana game again, and it's a welcome home. I feel like the rest of the series deserves to be remastered to this same degree. And that's why I'm biased. At the end of the day, no, I'm very biased towards this franchise, and I'm very excited to be able to play this game here in 2020. And I'm trying to encourage you to do the same, but obviously make the best financial decision with your time and your money when it comes to playing video games. I think you're going to get a lot out of this game. I think the game has a lot to offer, not only in its story, but to be able to replay with some of the different characters as the lead, especially the fact that you can skip through varying cutscenes. So if you start to see the same one over and over again, you can end up having a much more smooth and sped up experience overall. Now, with all of that, I do thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about this game, sound off in the comments below or check out my Getting Started guide for the game and see if it's something that you should pick up for yourself. If you've enjoyed this video, I hope that you hit that like button, subscribe, and ring that bell. It really does help. And if you're already subscribed, you will forever be my hero of time. That's what you get for subscribing, free compliments and titles with my videos. And I thank you for it. If you're a hero of time, let me know which one in the comments below. And with that, I wish you all the best. This has been Brian for Ginger Prime Gaming. And with that, I will see you in my next video. I hope you have a fantastic week. Take care.